First of all, without objection, Representative Nick Langworthy of New York has waived on the subcommittee for purpose of questioning witnesses at today's subcommittee hearing. And then we go to Mr. Burlison.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Appreciate you guys coming out today, testifying. Look, I've been here for 6 months, and I'm pretty skeptical. I don't trust anything in this town. And I think that's because I'm from Missouri. You've got to show me, right? With that being said, there's been a lot of things that have been said in the public, Mr. Grush. And so I want to get down to, if we can, some specifics, right? So at one point you had said that there has been harmful activity or aggressive activity. Mm-hmm. Has any of the activity been aggressive, been hostile in your reports?
I know of multiple colleagues of mine that got physically injured. And the activity, and I got to
By UAPs or by people within the federal government?
Both.
Okay, yeah. So there has been activity by alien or non-human technology and or beings that has caused harm to humans?
I can't get into the specifics in an open environment, but at least the activity that I personally witnessed, and I have to be very careful here, because they tell you never to acknowledge tradecraft, right? So what I personally witnessed, myself and my wife, was very disturbing.
Okay. One of my constituents actually sent this next question, and I figured I'd ask it since I had the same thought. You've said that U.S. has intact spacecraft. You said that the government has alien bodies or alien species. Have you seen the spacecraft?
I have to be careful to describe what I've seen firsthand and not in this environment, but I could answer that question behind closed doors.
Yeah. And have you seen any of the bodies?
That's something I've not witnessed myself.
Okay. And so with that being said, you know, and the other statement that has been made that was intriguing to me because, and it's intriguing because my view has been that we are billions of light years away from any other system. And the concept that an alien species that's technologically advanced enough to travel billions of light years gets here and somehow is incompetent enough to not survive Earth or crashes is something that I find a little bit far-fetched. And with that being said, you have mentioned that there's interdimensional potential. Could you expound on that?
I'll get to answer your first question, and you know I'm here as a fact witness and expert, but I will give you a theoretical framework at least to work off to kind of espouse crashes, regardless of your level of sentience, right? You know, planes crash, cars crash, n number of sorties, however high, a small percentage are going to end in mission failure, if you will, as we say in the Air Force, and then in terms of multidimensionality, that kind of thing, the framework that I'm familiar with, for example, is something called the holographic principle. It derives itself from general relativity and quantum mechanics, and that is, if you want to imagine a 3D object such as yourself casting a shadow onto a 2D surface, that's the holographic principle. So you can be projected, quasi-projected from higher dimensional space to lower dimensional. It's a scientific trope that you can actually cross, literally, as far as I understand, but there's probably guys with PhDs that we could probably argue about that.
But you have not seen any documentation that that's what's occurring.
Only a theoretical framework discussion. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Occam's razor is that these aircraft, have they been identified that they are being produced by domestic, military and contractors? Is there any evidence that that's what's being recovered?
Not to my knowledge, plus the recoveries predate a lot of our advanced programs that I previously am witting of. So,
would it be safe to say that there could be a scenario today where you have an aircraft that crashes and because it's been involved in one program from one federal agency, and the agency that retrieves it is not aware of that program, and to them it appears alien in origin?
I mean, that's a hypothetical situation. I'm not aware of any historical situation that would match that you described. So
you're not aware, it has not happened that you're aware of?
That I'm aware of.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I yield back.